dive from one awesome box of plastic to another. Monogram through Revell USA, who sent this kit over. 1969 Dodge SuperBee 440 6-pack, my favorite Mopar engine. 2-in-1 kit, skill level 4, 1/24th scale. 86 parts will make for quite an easy and fun build. Let's take a look at all the goodies that are inside the box. First up, that massive SuperBee body, that massive Coronet body on there. Check that thing out. Nice molding. Like the impressions along here, the faux venting. The molding is all nice and tight on this one. Should be relatively easy to do the trim. Oh yeah, you can always tell that look of that back window, that little smile with the tips of the lips on the side. Excellent molding. All under hood detail, and that's fine because on the real one, I'm pretty sure the firewall and the fenders are the body color. So you don't have to worry about that at all. Beautiful look on there. Let's get out the other 86 parts, or the other 85 parts. It's an 86 part kit. Put everything out here. We've got our 446 engine and transmission halves. We got our front suspension. We got part of our air cleaner. We got that 6-pack scoop. Check that out, molded with the slots in it. We got our intake. We got our hood. We've got our interior pan with nice detail on the inside. Pedals are molded in. These are very simple builds. We got our rear seat with our transmission tunnel. That'll be easy to paint up my main color and then accent the carpet and the flooring with a brush by hand. You've seen me do that and I enjoy doing it. Here's the 2-in-1 hood. Optional blower out. We got our blower intake. We got our blower belt and pulley system. And we got our suspension for the drag car. Those are little risers for the suspension. Speaking of the suspension, rear suspension, springs, differential, and exhaust all molded in one. Don't worry about it. This is super easy to hand paint. Spray it all your base color for the differential and springs, and then hand paint and detail it. Got our drive shaft, got body parts here, got our rear trim, radiator, fan, steering wheel, stock steering wheel on this one, stock manifolds coming off there with their down pipes. We've got, look how small those shocks are, nice and thin. We got a steering column, be very careful. Looks like the turn signal indicator there could break off easily. Got our distributor, got our water pump housing, oil filter, fuel pump, all in the front there. On the last white parts tree, we got the very large chassis and frame. We got our seat backs, we got our front bucket seats, we got our radiator surround. And we got our wheel backs on this one. Let's switch over to the other side of the desk. What do we got sitting over here? Well, we've got 4 standard tread. They're nice wide tires, tall tires like they would be in the old days. They weren't running low pros back then. There are no names on the firewall, no imprinting at all. We've got our glass, we've got our headlights, and our one-piece front, rear, and side glass. Looks nice, molded clear. You'll be able to see the interior without it being all distorted. We've got our optional wheels. We've got our headlight and grille assembly. Got our taillight assembly. Bumpers, front and rear. We've got our stock 5-spoke wheels. We got our 6-pack intake. Air cleaner, valve covers. Shifter, carburation for the blown version. Blower right there with the front and back. So you got a nice chrome tree, well done. I'll be working on that. And final part of the kit, new decals. We got the gorgeous stripes on the back end for all your options. We've got our bumblebee stripes all the way across the back. We've got our logos for the 446 barrel. We've got gauges, we've got hood pins. All our gauges, door locks, signals, factory stickers, 6-pack emblems for that flat black hood. More Bumblebee logos, license plates, check it out. BF Goodrich radial TA tire logos for those tires if you so choose. And turn signal indicators all on there, 440 emblems, everything. Beautiful decal sheet, tons of options on there. Never had problems with Revell decals. I'm gonna start gluing mine together and I'll be right back. I like how the assemblies are laid out on this, being not a billion parts. I could actually build this in little modules. Like the entire front suspension, you don't need to assemble 14 different pieces to get it go onto the chassis. It's just one large piece with nice detail, with torsion bars and your steering tie rods and your sway links and all that stuff. So I can paint this with the hood and the belt and pulley system and the bottom of the air cleaner, and then detail them as necessary individually and attach them later so that we've got separate paint colors on the vehicle. Same with the rear suspension, drive shaft, steering wheel, and dash. I can do all those in one color and detail them separately as I go. We got the radiator mount. That will be painted body color. Then we will attach the radiator assembly, which is right here, which I accidentally had detached from a parts tree, so I'll just have to clamp it, paint it my black, and then detail it in a second with some extra black when I'm done. This lower piece on the front end is part of the body work, so we'll need to paint that the same color as the body, so I have it on its own little tree where I can paint it up. Wheel backs I'll just do in either a metallic or a black. We got our radiator line there. We got our shocks we can paint individually now. This part of the rear trim work, the taillights and all that, I do want to paint that a dark color, then highlight it later. So a lot of these will be silver in the center, but I want to do mine in the black. So I will be painting this over. Then I can go in and detail everything and redo the silver trim. Is easier to do with a thin pen than it is to try to mask everything off and just get the little areas black. It's a lot easier to do for me. However you choose to do it is up to you. The master cylinder, I don't think, should be chrome, so I have that cut off, the chrome tree, and we'll be painting that. The wheels and the six-pack, three two-barrel carburetors, I will be flat coating them, then treating it with some Tamiya black wash. They'll look like real metal, and then I'll go in and in hand paint the individual centers to blacken those out and make those look like a nice set of wheels. The chassis needs no work at all. I just cut it free and we'll be able to get that painted and then spray some body color underneath and work on that. The interior is the same thing. Doesn't need any work. I just cut it free from its trees so I can clamp it, prime it black, spray it my interior color, and then I'll go in and hand paint the package shelf and the carpet. Is nice and fun to do. The bucket seats are ready to go, so we can just prime them. We got their backs on. They fit seamlessly. And there's a back on that. You can barely tell it. We'll get those painted. The beautiful 440 engine with its six-pack intake is all set up. I did attach the manifolds. There's not much of an attachment point for them, so I wanted to glue them on tight. I sanded the bottom of the valve covers so that I could use model glue on those. And everything else went together very nicely. We'll be able to hand pick out those manifolds and exhaust downpipes. But I want those valve covers painted the same color as the block, and I'll be able to paint that distributor. And the distributor will hold on much nicer with model paint than it does with super glue later. Model paint actually welds or melts the plastic, so it acts like it's welding. The air cleaner, you could leave chrome. I want to do a more stock car, so I will be priming that and painting over the chrome. For all of you guys that whine when I paint over chrome, I just read in the last issue of Scale Auto Magazine, the model master Tim Boyd, recognized as one of the best model builders that has ever lived, even says, I just paint over chrome when I need to. And he paints over for differentials, everything. He just paints right over it, just like I do. Well, the experts say it can't be done. Got the rear body piece on here. Let's look how seamless that fits. That just lines right up. Ran a bead of model glue on the inside, and that's held in tight. We'll be attaching our taillights over the top of that, and those little holes are for the bumper. So that's how easy this kit goes together. There is no issue with assembly. Look at that hood scoop when it goes on. Seamless. Beautiful. You have an actual open hood through the bottom. I just held it on, ran a bead of glue around the bottom, and it's all done, and it looks fantastic. So, very easy to work on. We're going to get this all into paint right now.
Thank you.
getting her done on my build. Check out that body. She's got some sexy lines. I love how that Shortcuts flat black looks much more like it than just leaving it black primer, which has a rougher texture. You can see it's smooth, but also flat. I used a silver pen to do the hood pins on there. It does have decals for the other hood for the hood pins, and if you wanted to sand off the molded in hood pins, but I think they look quite nice. You can see them on there. They look real sweet. So that's it. The body is ready to go. Got all the things that we got the rear in with the tail light glued in. That looks nice, so that's all set. The interior is ready to be pushed inside. I didn't use any of the decals on the interior, decided to do it all by hand. If you want to see how I did those gauges and all that, check out the Richard Petty review I just did of the 92 Pontiac. Shows how I use a silver pen and a silver pencil, both of them combined, to go in there and do those dash gauges for me, just because I felt like doing it, and then wood grained it, clear coated it, just like I showed in the how-to section. That looks lovely in there. That's ready to go. And then we've got that white chiffon interior, that off-white color. We've got our radiator surround that will push in after we get the body on the chassis. We got the rear bumper cut free. We got the front grille and body molding underneath it with the black stripe down the center. Just needs the SuperBee decal on there. We've got our turn signals on the front bumper colored in and dried up. We got our master cylinder. We got our six-pack intake. We got the radiator line right there. We've got the engine, transmission, and chassis package. You can see the top of that big 440 right there. Looking good. With its fan and alternator on it, and its six-pack intake with its transmission. Underneath, nice-looking newish or resto car, whatever. I don't go for perfect factory restorations, but I wanted to make it look pretty nice underneath there. Contrasting colors between the silver and the steel. Got our wheel and tire package painted up and on there. Word for the wise on that wheel and tire package, there's a lip on the outside of the tire where this wheel, the actual wheel, is supposed to go instead of the wheel back. When I pushed it in, I did have to use pliers. Those vinyl tires fit super tight around there, and the wheels will stand proud unless you press them in there with something pretty strong. And I got big hands, and my thumbs couldn't get them in there, so I just used a pair of pliers, got them in there. But we got our shocks on, suspension, all detailed, framework and all. It looks pretty nice. Looks newish. They've owned it for at least a year. So that's going to settle down over the top. We're going to get everything pushed together. I'm going to decide whether I want to go black or white. If I want to use these stripes here, the hockey stripes, all depends on which ones you want to use. Dress up the tires if you wish. Get your emblems on there. And I will be right back with my final. Nobody wants to get stung by this bee. My favorite kind of Mopars are the ones with the fiberglass hoods and the six-pack on the side of the giant scoop with the four hood pins. You gotta have two guys to take the hood off. It is a sweet car. Revell's through monogram 1969 Dodge SuperBee 440 six-pack car in sky blue metallic with the white bumblebee striper on the back end, the blacked out hood, the stock wheels, but the modern radial TA tires on it. 2-in-1 kit. You could build it as a dragster, or you can build it stockish like mine. I love that white interior I did in there with the black dash and the fancy upgraded wood grain. The silver trim really stands out against that blue, and all the parts go together so easy. There's only 86 parts in the kit, and it assembles super uncomplicated. An easy first glue kit for anyone. You're not going to have to fight with anything. You can see that you can get stuff glued together and not have to fight with where pipes go and all this other stuff. It just looks awesome, and everything lines up, and you can do it in modules like I did with the differentials and stuff and paint them separately and put them on. Makes detailing easier. Of course, you could paint the hood a factory color. You could use the other hood. You can use all the different stripes that they include. Hockey stripes and the wraparound stripes with the big SuperBee logos. You got all kinds of stuff left over. You got the black bumblebee stripes for the back end. You got all kinds of stuff on there that you can use in other builds. And the gauges are molded so nice, I didn't even use the gauge decals, which are always great from Revell. So those are saved over for a kit that doesn't have them. It's a nice big kit because the SuperBees were big cars off the Coronet there. So They are a nice size. I like how that paint came out. Everything laid down smooth. Brushed on two coats of Future, but not on the hood. We left the hood that flat black from the Krylon Shortcuts can. So the decals all went on easily. I didn't have any problem with cracking or ripping. I did break one of the BF Goodrich decals, but I was able to line it back up just fine. I was a little ham-fisted when I was pressing it on, and you can see those lay on those tires super nice. But if you don't want to use them on this car, go ahead and use them on something else. I think radial TAs are the choice tire for muscle cars. They just look really good on them, and I'm really glad that Revell USA put those tire decals in the box, because that just sets off a model ever so bit with those stock wheels. It just really makes it look nice. So we thank Revell USA for sending this over. Model Roundup has this in stock right now. So you can order 1, 2, 3. You can order a whole box of them. They got the best price on the internet for them. I will link down in the description where you can snag them from Model Roundup. Remember, as always, I am not Model Roundup. I don't own the company. They're just a cool channel sponsor, so I like to throw business their way every single time I can, because they're such a nice group of guys over there. And Revell doesn't have an in-house mail order place, so I send you all over there where they got great prices and great service. Again, thanks to Revell USA. Thanks to Model Roundup for supporting the show. Thanks to all you cool viewers. Build your models your way. Have fun. Don't sweat the small stuff. Don't pet the sweaty stuff. And we will see you at the next review.